So, hey everyone, I just thought I'd try and finish this one this week. I was looking at things and I noticed that a lot of people try and do one page a week. I'll see how I go depending on time, but I'm thinking that would be something that I would like to start trying to do. So, what I've decided, I'm not totally certain of the colours for everything, but I know for these eight leaves here, I'm going to do like a purpley bluish coloured leaf, just because I figured I kind of still tossing up about the green leaves, but I really like how the different coloured leaves are going for the top image, so I may sort of do the more unusual out there leaves. I have zoomed in again, so hopefully that's okay. The colours I've decided I'm using for these little ivy sort of leaves here is a black, they're Prismacolor Premier 150 set again, but black grape PC996, cobalt blue hue PC133, light aqua PC992, and a powder blue PC1087. As usual, I may or may not use all the tones. We just have to wait and see. And then, as usual, I also have my black PC935 for shadows and shading and tones and stuff like that. So, and my, yeah, is my eraser and sharpener. It's to the side there in case I need it. My cloth. I'll work out the other tones as I go. I'll set those there for now. I'm going to start with my black grape. And I'm just going to do a bit around. Actually haven't used this black grape colour before. It's prettier than I realised, so working out where I want the lights coming from in each leaf as I do it. So if I pause for a minute in between, so I'm doing each leaf with the one hue on this side first. So if I pause for a minute thinking, you know why. Thank you. And that's the black grape. Next I'm going to go in with my cobalt blue hue. And I'm going to mix that right into it as well. Three colours again, by the looks of it. So. I think because the powder blue, I think we're only going to fit the three tones, so I'm just going to finish it with the light aqua. I'm going to blend that all the way up into. To highlight a few of those shadows. And I'm going to go back in with my black grape. I'm going to blend some of that in to do the hair. It's a cobalt blue hue. Oops. This one seems to be picking up the purple colour really easily for some reason and wiping it off. Doesn't do it again. Has done it a bit. No, I don't know what it is with this cobalt blue hue, but it seems to be slightly different when it comes to layering over things. As you can tell there, it's taking the colour off in the double layer. So I'm not sure what's going on there. I'm probably not going to do too much more with the cobalt blue hue than that, just because it is taking colour off for some reason, rather than adding it. Another blue I can add in there as a substitute in the meantime. I'm going to try this China blue, see if that helps fill it in a bit. Yeah, that does. I don't know why, it's the first time I've used that cobalt blue hue pencil before, and for some reason it feels a lot softer and more sort of chalky than some of the other colours. So I don't quite know what's going on there. But that's better. Switching pencils. So you might want to instead substitute with the China Blue, which is PC1100. Make sure it works properly, and I'm not going to bring the green up over every colour this time. I just want it over those blues and that, just to try and blend them in a bit better. And yeah, that's those. I'll just pause for a minute, then I'll come back and do the other side in the same colours, but I think rather than using the cobalt blue hue, which for some reason is a really, like, the lid kind of feels similar, but it seems to go chalky, so don't know. I might just use that for ones where it's the main colour or something, but it was rubbing the colour off, so I'll probably just instead swapped the China blue for the next side. Anyway, so I'll be back shortly. Okay, so I'm back. Sorry, just checking that it was focused. Yeah, I've decided that I'm going to go with that China blue instead, just because of the cobalt blue here rubbing the colours off. But, like, it's still a nice colour. I did a sample test here. That's the colour that it is there. But, yeah, it just seems a bit more, I don't know, slightly different to the other colours, so who knows. So yeah, I'll just make some adjustments instead. So this time we're using a black grape again. Actually, I'll probably just do this side silent since I did that side talking. So yeah, I'll be back once I've done this bit here. Thank you. that's those leaves. I just had a thought. I realized it might actually be, I might have just been pressing a little too hard. It might not be the pencil at all. I might just have been accidentally pressing a little hard so it didn't go on quite as well. Instead, it rubbed the color off a bit or something. At least that's a thought that I had anyway. So I'm just touching up these areas here that need it. But yeah, I was just thinking maybe I was just layering just a little too firm and hence it caused the colour to start coming off instead as I put it on. So, could be a possibility. There is quite a difference. Well, I used it two different tones, I guess, so. But yours would be more similar, but yeah, so could be just that I was pressing a little hard, or it could be that there was something with the pencil. But yeah, anyway, I'll be back in a bit and I'll start another leaf type. I'm just sort of thinking which leaf, because there's multiple different types of leaves here, so I'll work that out and then I'll be back. Okay, so I'm back. I'm thinking I want to do another bluey toned leaf with the parrot green, with the ultramarine PC902, peacock blue PC1027, and parrot green PC1006. And I'm going to do these two leaves here with those colours, just to work it in with these ones. I'm still not sure what happened there, whether I was pressing too hard or whether it was the pencil colour or what. I'm sort of confused. I spent a bit of time thinking about it. I'm still confused. So I don't know what was happening or whatever, but I guess what happens, happens. I'm not going to not use that cobalt blue here because it's a pretty hue, so I guess I'll work it out in time. This one, it looks like I do need to keep the stem in this one, just from what I can see. I'm starting with my ultramarine, and I'm going to bring, I'm just trying to shadow a bit lighter, and then I'll bring it in darker just because I'm sort of not sure if that was part of the issue before, or sometimes I do press a little firmer sometimes without realizing it. It's quite easy to do for me anyway. We'll also use our black, which is PC935, for shadows after. I'm just going to darken that up a bit. Peacock blue. I'm just gonna do light shadows again. I'm wondering if the peacock green, parrot green, might be a little close to the peacock blue, so I may use a lighter blue instead. Or a lighter green. Actually, yes. Sorry. Changing my mind as I go. I've just decided I'll use a Chartuse PC989 instead of the parrot green. So I'm gonna leave the parrot green out and use the Chartuse instead, which is like a brighter green. And I'm colouring all over this leaf again with this colour. Just blending it all in. I'm going to bring that right up over all the other colours, sort of blending them. This will make it look more greeny though than the blues. And those spots where it is. More green now, but that works. Stem, I think I'll go with the dark green. If I can get it to colour in that spot, which nope. It's not. Not yet. Don't know whether it's hot. Maybe it's because it's hot. It's 38 degrees here, but I've got the aircon on, so that shouldn't be affecting my pencils. I just keep feeling them stick and stuff today, so I keep checking. But the dark green is PC908. So that's that one, and I'll just do the next one. Quiet, and yeah.
Thank you.
it seems to be a lot more pencil colour coming off than usual with the shaving kind of things. So I'm kind of not sure, because I haven't had this problem before, so whether it's the heat or... what, I don't know. Totally baffled because it feels like the pencils are kind of sticking when they start rubbing the colour off, so maybe it's just too many layers on there or something, but then I haven't done that many layers, so I'm only doing what I usually do, so it might be the fact that I've got a hot lamp here for recording the stuff, and it's 38 degrees outside, and yeah, my little corner, the aircon doesn't reach properly, so I've also got my fan on, which is what you can hear there in the background. So yeah, who knows? I can't work it out. I'm stumped. Still have to go in with my black. Just putting a bit of a line down where the dark lines go with the stem. Do it just with the black and the little bit of ultramarine around where the black goes. I'm not going to be able to erase that without erasing part of the colours that I've done. And then you can't get the colour properly back on the page again, I've noticed. Well, most of the time anyway. So I'll just leave it. Okay. I'll leave it at that bit. Sorry, I don't know why I'm having so many troubles with the pencil colours and stuff this time. Yeah, could be multiple things, I guess. Don't like it when I can't work something out. Yes, it looks like I missed one of those little ivy leaves there too. I'll just quickly do that. The camera for a bit. I'll probably try and do these couple of leaves here and then I'll probably leave it at that for now. So yeah, be back. So back. Sorry if it went out of focus at the end there. I pressed the wrong button when stopping the video. I've been thinking about how much more I want to do with this video, because it's coming up to around an hour. It'll probably be over an hour by the time it's done. But I've decided I'm going to do these last couple of leaves here, and then next time I'm thinking I'll probably try and finish it off by doing the branches and these little leaves and these few leaves up here. And then I'm still undecided on background or no background. In some ways I'm thinking it's going to be hard to choose a background colour just because of the colours, so I might just leave it white because I've used so many different colours on it. So I'm thinking background may not suit unless it was something like greys or something that could possibly work, because I've just used so many colours that sort of you can't go with one particular colour without risking blending it out, so grey would probably be the only colour choice. But then at the same time I don't know that I want the background grey or whatever, because it's going to be, because it's so small. So anyway, I'll think about that. Background may or may not happen. I'm not sure if I want a background with it, so yeah, background may just be left out. I may just leave it as it is, because I'm quite happy with it as it is without the background on this one. I think I showed in a previous video, I think I showed this one that I did, like the wreath type thing, this one. Sorry, I'll zoom out a bit so you can see it properly. But yeah, you'll see this is the wreath. I made it like a sort of jungle wreath with the way it looked and that. But yeah, just with this one, I'm just not sure that it's that I really sort of want a background on it, so yeah, I'll just check it's focused. So yeah, I'll probably just leave this one without a background. So yeah, anyway, colours I've decided on for these first two leaves, I've decided to go with more of the the pinks and stuff again, just because I'm really liking how it's turning out with the sort of different colours up in this top one. So I decided to go with more pinks and purples. So I'm going with the violet PC932. I'm going with magenta PC930. And I'm going with hot pink PC993 for these ones. And I'm not going to worry about the outer rim or whatever on them. So my cloth thing again. So yeah. I'm just gonna start with the violet on this one. Next, I'm going to go in with the magenta. I'm going to colour this completely over the violet. Create a bit more shadow. Doesn't have quite enough blending. Fade that out lightly. And we're going to bring in our hot pink. Yeah, that finish. And we'll blend all those layers in together again. Same thing again. What is causing this today? Unless I've got something under the page that's causing it. Sorry, just tipping that off. There's a bit of dog hair under there, so maybe that was causing it. I'm gonna now go in with my black. Just around the edges again. And we're gonna go in with our violet again. magenta. Adding in again. A hot pink that we're adding in last, and I'm not going to bring that fully up into the purple this time just because I'm finishing it off. So yeah, that's that one, and I'll just go and do this other one quietly. And yeah, that's done. I'm going to go in and do the last two leaves of this one. And for that I'm going to go with like a bluey toned leaf, which was what I was planning up here, but that ended up green, which is fine. So I'm going to go with the Indanthrone blue PC908. I'll spell it out in the comments because I'm short-sighted, so I couldn't read that from the distance I had it. Muted Turquoise PC1088 and Cerulean Blue PC103. So I'm going to use that for these final leaves. Starting with the Indanthrone blue, I think it's called. Cerulean blue. I'm going to color that completely over that blue. And just add a bit of a light in there. And then we're going to go in with our muted turquoise. I'm going to put that over the entire thing. And I think I've coloured over the other leaf a bit because I can't tell too much of a difference between them at the moment. Well, you can, but yeah, it's just the dark tones. Now I'm going to go in with my black outline. Back in with that Indanthrone blue, and that'll probably be where seems quite dark that one. That'll have to do. And I'll just do the other leaf the same. I'll just do it quietly. I'll leave it at that for now, and I'll see you next time when I'll probably try to finish this off, see how things go, but there's not too much left, so I think I'll probably finish it off next video. Yeah, talk to you later. Bye.